all I can say is somebody's really upset about something. Tell me how excited you are. Tell me in numbers what this will do. Why is this so much better? It's a variant of finances, outcomes, approach, I suppose. We all actually insist on numbers. I think it's worth, it's a very worthy thing to do if you ever seek to get some accolades for your program. Tell us, show us what impressions. The variant of that is don't expect journalists to defend you or your program. Even though you get on really well with us, and we get on really well with you, we might see you in Aldi or Costco or Woolworths and you say hi or anything like that. You're not about promoting or defending your program, no matter what you write about it at some stage or another. There are people, broadcasters, that might do that, but most IT journalists might. Are we friends? Are we foes? A good example of that is some of my best friends are actually quite high up in government. One of my best friends is John Miller, the Information Commissioner. John and I started out together as part of the media. It's not to get to it goes back to about 1973, actually. Open media is designed to open up discussion about media communications, accountable broadcasting media then. And John and a few others are good friends. Another one was the Ombudsman, etc. But I talk with John, when I talk with John in a professional capacity, John also responds to me in a professional capacity. So the aim of any person concerned with advancing government is to aim for respect, which means at times we disagree. But at least you will concede each other have a point of view as a perspective. And that is the most important thing that most journalists try to convey. We do respect. The fact that an envy indicates, or ask you a question indicates, we have respect for you. Not because we think you've got a really great program. And that's the most important thing. Can you explain this? story? Why is this newsworthy? Why should I know about this? How will this amuse or educate or enrage my readership? If you can't answer that, that story won't fly. But I think it's also a matter of time. Most journalists have got Twitter accounts, and you get a feeling of how they operate. That some journalists are absolutely 100% behind this, like Renato May, to the Earth. He's very strong on it. Josh Taylor, a few out of it. But they've got time, frankly, to do that. I mean, I'm on Twitter. I'm pragmatic 45 or people. But I haven't got the time to invest in really extensive things of that kind. And I'm not on Twitter when I haven't had a Twitter open and I'm looking at a story and something catches. I think it's a passing phase, though.